I just had a very sobering and very inspiring visit to Marjorie Stoneman Douglas High School. I want to thank Principal Ty Thompson and Assistant Principal Denise Reed for their hospitality and their kindness in bringing me around the school and helping me meet many of the faculty, many of the students, much of the leadership from this community. It was a very, as I said, sobering and inspiring moment and visit. I heard a variety of things from the students that I spoke with. Some of them are doing quite well, but they all acknowledge that it's a day-to-day situation. For students who were actually in the building involved, it's very tough. I did note, however, there are a number of helper dogs around the school, comfort dogs, and I spoke with a small group of students that are having a particularly tough time. And when I asked them about if any of them had had opportunity to connect with the dogs, all of their faces lit up in an amazing way. So that was encouraging. We've had a number of listening sessions already. We will have more. And we are committed not only to listening, but to action. We know that there are many common solutions that we can find common ground on, and we are committed to furthering and advancing those things that are going to help ensure that students like these and all those across the country are going to have the opportunity to learn in safe environments. Well, let's be clear. I think it's to say arming teachers is an oversimplification and a mischaracterization, really. I think the concept is to, for those schools and those communities that opt to do this, as they have in Texas and as they have in Polk County and other places around the country, to have people who are expert in being able to defend and having lots and lots of training in order to do so. Polk County is a great example here, where those who are deputized within the school personnel, I don't know if there may be some teachers, there's probably other school personnel as well, but they are required and requested to do training above and beyond what the deputies in that county actually train to. So the standards are held very, very high. And I think that's a model that can be adopted and should be an option for schools, for states, for communities, but it's certainly not one that needs to be required or mandated for every community.